Do you ever watch a movie with your parents and then all of a sudden this happens?
Was
About it.
joking.
It's like,
I think
but
you take things really sensitively, and that's fine. I
no, I
just
just
need
thought
to
it
not
was.
make those jokes with you.
No, I don't think they're. I think they're just like rude.
But to me, it's a joke. To you, it's rude. So I won't make them to you because you don't take it the way that I'm meaning.
So, I've been told to tone down my support for the LGBT community, specifically the trans community, because I might make people who have differing beliefs feel uncomfortable sharing their opinions. And all I can say is, good. You should feel uncomfortable with your hate.
I'm Stan and I was wrong. I'm singing the Stan Wrong song. I shouldn't have taken that chance. Now here's my remorseful dance.
So some wise guy pranked me and put a bumper sticker on my car. And, you know, I can't have people thinking I'm a vegan. Like, what the?
I can't focus on what needs to get done. I'm on notice, hoping that you don't run.
Okay, so people are getting mad on Twitter because in the new Animal Crossing game, style doesn't coordinate with pronouns, and all the villagers use they, them pronouns for you no matter what. And you know what? I agree. It would be so hard if every day people just use the wrong pronouns for you constantly. Like, can you imagine?
Okay, I am going to preface this by saying that I am a lesbian, although not a seasoned one. I'm almost 19. I've identified as bisexual for most of my life until really recently when I came out as lesbian. I've noticed something in the community of queer women that I don't know if other people have noticed, so let me know if you've noticed this. Lesbians do their darndest to separate themselves from other women who like women. When I identified as bisexual, there was always this sentiment from lesbians that I didn't belong with them. And yeah, I get it, like, bi people and lesbians have different experiences with discrimination. But if I wanted to seek out advice or support, I couldn't go to lesbian women because there was always this underlying current saying that I wasn't gay enough. And this separation is a lot of a reason why it took me so long to come out as lesbian, because I've been told over and over again that I wasn't like them. So is this like exclusivity real, or is it just me?
I just want to know. Knows. Do you think he's aware? Or do you think he like saw these at a thrift store and was like, damn, these some fire ass shoes, and then coordinated his outfit for this picture? And he's like, damn, these Instabigs better be fire.
Congrats on coming out, queen! We love you!
I want to dress you up. Oh my gosh, you'd look so good.
I'd look like a cross-dressing Ken doll.
So when did you, like, turn gay?
When I wanted to put life on hard mode.
Oh yeah, separate tabs, please. We're not together. No, I'm straight, actually.
Oh my God.
Be honest, did you really never have a crush
on? No, you have a foot fetish, and I'm not into that.
Oh my God, that table over there keeps looking at us.
I think their waiter's just coming. No, I think their waiter's just coming.
We're not. So you'd, like, never sleep with a guy. Like,
why would I choose to be unsatisfied?
I mean, I'm not gay. Like, you know that. I'm not gay.
Yeah.
I love boys.
Bet.
But if I was gonna sleep with a girl, I'd probably be...
It's kinda gay.
Yeah, no. I went to the gay bar, like,
you're wearing a Nike sports bra.
You're
wearing a Nike sports bra. You're wearing a Nike sports bra! You're wearing a Nike sports bra.
Wild. So you've, like, never checked me out?
Disgusting.
Ladies, I advise you to try this. Put your phone down on your bed and see what you look like on top.
I look like this, so I'm never being on top.
Ooh.
but hi. I'm so glad you could make it.
Oh yeah, no bother. Thanks for having me over.
Right, get your drink out. We're playing Never Have I Ever.
Oh, fun. That's a vibe.
Right, lad.
Hi.
Okay, me first. Never have I ever been in a threesome.
Two girls at once. Lucky bastard. Nah, mate, it was a boy and a girl.
I found one. Finally, a gay best friend.
No, I'm not gay. Wait, so like, you looked at the boy journal? Yeah. Oh, couldn't do that, man.
Not to think the coronavirus was like a year ago.
Hey.
Hi.
So, do you want to have a threesome with us?
Yep.
So, as it turns out, being gay must run in the family. Because somebody chewed through my new underwear like a big, dumb lesbian.
I'd have one nickel, but the fact that that even happened is so fucked.
I'm such a fucking idiot. So I'm driving around, and there's this big lifted truck that pulls in front of me, and I look at his license plate, and it's like custom, and it said like IM and then BTMN. And I looked at it for a second, and I was just sitting there, and then I'm like, I'm bottoming? And I just had to loudly profess that to myself, apparently, even though it was clearly, I'm Batman, you gay idiot.
Okay, number three, the straight boy. Now, the straight boy is a wild creature because he's just curious. I mean, he's going to end up with a woman, but he wants to adventure. Hot. It's wrong, that's why it's hot. Number two, sexy European guy in my apartment complex. His name was Alejandro, and let me tell you, he had an 8-pack. He had a sexy accent, and wow, did he eat ass. Number one. Mean, self-entitled, brown-haired, blue-eyed, fuck boys. Preferably the ones who wear their hat backwards. Yes, please? That's all.
People keep asking me why am I so underrated on here, and it's because TikTok likes white lesbians. I mean, I just come to the fact that that's just what it is. And honestly, I'm really not tripping about it. I'm gonna get whatever clout I got on here, and I'm appreciative of it. So it is what it is.
Hey, do you wanna split that cookie?
Huh? Wait. Oh.
Oh, never mind. I thought. Sorry.
Oh, no, gay, me gay. Me gay too.
I'm out here on the come up. I beat the pussy drummer. I roll up no more drama. Womp, womp, she give me what I wanna.
Okay, so since a lot of you straight boys think it's so funny to come out of the closet as a joke, let me just explain my experience coming out of the closet and how funny it was. So when I came out my freshman year, my parents were not okay with it, and my dad told me that he would rather me be than have a son that was gay. So I tried to do it. Well, police found me in a park, almost passed out, and I had to go to a mental hospital. My parents would not check me out of the mental hospital until I told everybody I was straight. They would bring a religious figure into the mental hospital every day instead of visiting me during family time to tell me how I was supposed to go to hell for everything I was doing. Let me throw some facts out here for you. 20% of LGBT homeless youth have to sell their bodies. 60% are abusing drugs, and almost 70% don't make it. So I'm so glad that you think this is so funny, but there's a lot of people dying while you're laughing and they can't sleep in their own bed at night like you can.
Hey, guys.
Shut the fuck up!
Fuck you!
Shut up! Jesus!
Fucking stop!
I hate you!
Nobody loved you!
Fuck you.
I still can't believe this happened the other day. Now it's time for part two. I asked him out to dinner, but he said how, and I had to do some thinking. But first, I needed to freshen up, so I shaved, brushed, flossed, and lifted my cinder blocks. The barbershop is closed, so I cut my own hair. Next up was finding the perfect fit. Okay, this one. 2 a.m. hits, and it was time for our date. I waved from behind the glass, and he waved back. I told him he looked beautiful.
You look beautiful!
I set up the study lounge earlier to prepare for our date. The date was going so well, he started to queue up 5 feet apart. Depending on how long this quarantine lasts, I might be in a long-distance relationship with someone who lives down the hall from me. I excused myself to go to the bathroom. Of course, I didn't have to go. I just wanted to text my homies about how well it was going. But first, I looked in the mirror and took a deep breath. It's time to take this relationship to the next level. Like for part three!
Bring the beat, life like journal. Young gang star, flip the kill switch. Jojo, pose, pose, pose. Jojo. Pose, pose, pose,
Jojo. Say it again.
What did you just say?
She's really hot. What is that?
Say it again.
No.
She said he doesn't even know how to do it right.
Those glasses are too big for his face. Big glasses.
I can't really
nice
see his face.
Nice eyebrows.
He looks sensitive.
Nice eyes. Yeah.
Sweet. I don't trust him.
Really? I like his hat.
No, I don't trust him.
What?
What's he trying to do?
He looks kind of like a lesbian.
Do you have any women that can show us? She's cute.
Mom, stop.
Okay, this one's for the ladies, so if you ain't a lady, keep on scrolling, Buster. Gays, queers, you can say too. I'll wait. Okay, listen, do you guys have a favorite brand of douche that you're using? Because I've been searching. All right, now they're definitely gone. I want you to listen closely, okay? If you really hate someone, I'm talking absolutely despise that person, and you want to make their life just a little bit harder, this is what you're going to do. You're going to find out every single way to contact that person. I am talking phone number, email, work email, home address. I don't care if it's their goddamn parents' country house. You're going to get that address, and you're going to go over to the Scientology website and sign them up for the Scientology mailing list. They'll never leave them alone. They'll be harassed by Scientologists for the rest of their life. They'll get calls, emails. I wouldn't be surprised if a goddamn Scientologist showed up on their doorstep one day. But you can't do it as soon as you guys have a fight. You need to wait a little while, okay? Ease into it. Give them their phone number one day. Give them their email address the next month. Their home address a couple months later. You have to be slow so they don't know. And the best part about it is that if there's anyone crazier than us, it's Scientologists. If they move, they'll find them. Change their phone number, they'll find them. And we call that what? Working smart, not hard, ladies.
So, we just figured out what my wife's type is.
I've never known anyone else to do this except for every single one of my exes.
Now, I don't think it's that weird, but apparently it is, and it's drinking pickle juice.
Meow.